6. And ayan, na-record na, no? Meron pa tayong module 6. So next week start tayo sa module 5. And then that will be 2 weeks. And then module 6. So tamang-tama na, no? Kasi your final exam will be on the December 15, 16, and 17. That will be on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So after your final exam, there will be no more classes, no more activities, or other quizzes. So you just wait for the teachers to announce your final grade. And then, you know, if ever you will have, you will receive a private message after the final exam, no? You'll receive a private message from me requiring you, for example, kasi baka nagkulangan kayo ng grade, so I will require you to to do the activities yung na hindi nyo na-submit, so mag-re-require niya ako. Pero pag if ever, no, wala po kayo natanggap, so you just wait na lang for the grade nyo po. So yung grade, hindi ko po ibibigay yan sa group chat. For, para sa privacy naman, ibibigay ko yan individually sa inyong messenger, as a message nyo, no? Hindi yan sa group chat natin kasi, siyempre, that's a private information. So, individual ko yun isi-send, okay? You just wait until January for me to give the grace. Siyempre, no? After the December 15, 16, 17, malapit na po ang Christmas season. Siyempre, magbabakasyon muna tayo. Pero, habang may time, I can compute some of the grades para by January ay magawa na. Yes? Okay.
Hi, ma'am. Hi, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, ilang months po, ma'am, yung vacation, ma'am?
Actually, no, dito sa school calendar ng school, ng trade school, let me see, no? It says here that January 15, 16, 17 is your final exam. So after that, you're going to have your semestral break. Kasama na din ang Christmas break from December 20 hanggang January 7. So, your January 7, first Friday mas naman to. Ang sinabi dito is January 17 is the first classes, January 17 will be the classes for your second semester. So it means that before January 17, you need to start enrolling na. Yon. Okay? So that's it, no? So since it's already recorded, so I'm going to continue now because baka later on ay mag-brownout din ako dito sa school kasi umulan, may team talaga ang langit, kalangitan, yan. So, I need to continue na so that if ever mag-brownout ay natapos, may na-discuss na ako or malapit na ako matapos. So, we will continue na on the module 4 by next, module 5 by next week. Kasi dalawang module pa to, I need to tackle all of it before mag-end yung, before ang final exam schedule. Okay? So, going back, so, we'll start now, no? So, this point visceral correlation coefficient is another way in getting the correlation. Ano yung sinabi ko last meeting yung correlation? Correlation is the relationship between the two variables. So, yan, no? So, wait lang, ha? May tawag kasi ako.
Hi, ma'am.
Sandali lang, ha? Wait lang, ha? For a while.
Hi, ma'am.
Okay, sorry for that. Okay, going back, so this is a kind of correlation that measures the strength of association between a continuous level variable, which is your ratio or interval data, and a binary variable. Yan. Ang focus niya lang din is to measure the relationship. But this time, ang tinetest niya is a real dichotomous and an interval sets of data. Okay, so we have here, X is the continuous variable and the Y is the dichotomous variable. So this is the formula for the point visceral correlation coefficient. Okay, for example, we have a data here. So you have 4 girls and 5 boys. So bakit may girls is 1? Patanungin nyo, ma'am, bakit may boys 2? So nandito po, ginamitan natin yung kanyang number. Ay, sorry, dito pala. Yan. So this is, hindi na po natin kailangan kasi sa statistics, there's no need for us to put the, dyan, lagay mo talaga yung word, girls, boys. So ginagamit po natin is number, wherein sasabihin na natin si girls is si 1, si boys si 2. Parang legend na yan. Tapos ilalagay na lang natin 1, 2. Sino yung girls dyan, lagay ng 1. Sino yung boys dyan, lagay ng 2. And then, so these 4 girls and 5 boys, they are of grade 12. That is why we have 9 students, no? Kasi 4 girls, 4 plus the 5, that is 9. So we have 9 students comprising of 4 girls and 5 boys. They took the, where's my, they took my 20-item mathematics achievement test. So the results are given below. So these are the results of the achievement test. Out of 20, kasi 20 items, so merong nag 10, merong nag 9, merong nag 10, 17, 18, 8, 10, 12, and 19. So out of 20 points yan. Okay, so this example we will use the point visceral relation, correlation. Bakit si point visceral correlation yung gagamitin natin? It's because we have a continuous interval data, which is your test results. This is the test result, and this is daw a continuous interval data. So, si continuous, it means that iba-iba yung range na kanilang scores. While the nominal dichotomous data, so meron po tayong fixed na number, like the gender, so wherein 1 is girls and 5 is boys. Unlike sa achievement test, depende po kung sino yung nakakuha ng 10, ng 9, sa 20. So that is what we call the continuous interval data. Okay, so for example, no, we have the X to be continuous variable and Y to be dichotomous variable, which is the female and the male. So ayan, kinuha po natin yung kanyang formula. So going back, how did we get the mean? Diba ang mean, we will go separate the female and the male, diba? Sineparate na natin yung gender 1, which is the girls, gender 2, which is the boys. Ayan. Tapos dito yung kanilang exam, I mean kanilang results. So we get the mean. So yung mean, you all know this is the mean. Pag may bar, that is the mean. So 9 plus 10, i-add lang natin and divide by ilan yan sila. So there are 5, so divide it by 5. Ayan, we get the mean of 13.6. For the girls, we have the mean of 11.25. So ganun po yung pagkuha muna, no? Get the mean of the males and get the mean of the females. Ayan. So going the doing all, meron naman tayo, kinuha naman natin yung mean ng ating overall, yung lahat, kasama na ang male at saka ng female. So this is the mean. which is a 12.56. Ito naman, kinuha yan, 10 minus the mean, ayan, nakuha. 9 minus the mean, yan po yung answer. 10 minus the mean, and so on. And then, square it para ilagay dito. Yung answer dito, multiply to itself by 2, yan, makuha ito. And then, get their sum, and their sum is 144.2224. So, ganun po yung process sa point viscera. Okay, after that, after doing it, you just substitute it to the formula here. But take note, kailangan natin kunin itong standard deviation. So, si standard deviation is this one. Ito yung kanyang formula. So, yung kanyang formula, you just substitute it para wait lang. Yan, standard deviation, ito yung formula, just substitute the value, and we get the 4.24559. And then, substitute, we have the exact one, the mean of male, the girls, and the mean of females, and then divided by the square root of, ano to? Ang N1, ibig sabihin, the number of males. The number of girls, the number of boys. Ayan. Pag wala siyang sub, ibig sabihin, all of the populations. Like, there are 9 students. So, 9. 9 po yung gagamitin natin. Okay? And then, doing the operations, we get this one. So, since this is the correlation, it's indicating that there is a low. Kasi mababa talaga, 0.02 something. This is a low. And this is a negative sign, so therefore, there is a low negative correlation. So, ibig sabihin, pag merong low negative correlations, it means that the higher the boy scores in the exam, the lower are the girl scores. So, opposite po sila. Kung mababa din yung scores ni boys, mataas yung score ni girl. So, opposite siya kasi negative yung kanilang correlation. Opposite yung kanilang direction of data. Ayan. So, that's it, no? I will not give the activities for this one, which is to evaluate. Kasi konti lang yung time natin. Pag face-to-face kasi, pwede po yan. Pero since it's an online, so depende kasi minsan sa connection. Minsan wala tayo nag-meet. So, yun. So, since I will not give this one, so just prepare for the Thursday quiz number 4. Okay?
Ayan. Hi, ma'am.
So, I'm done with the unit 2 of the statistics. Ito kasi dapat yun, no? So, skip natin yan. So, I'm going to focus.
Po, ma'am.
Yes.
Halos lahat po ng quiz, ma'am. Yan po ilabas, ma'am.
Yes, quiz number 3 will be focusing, quiz number 4 will be focusing on the topic of the module 4. Yun. So, if there will be no computation, pero I know there will be a computation in the, what is the mean, what is the mode, so mayroon ganyan. But it's a multiple choice. Pero pag wala, mostly, yung sample yung sa unit 2, yung sa correlations, there will be more on the definition. Okay? So, just read the topic. Now, ibigay ko naman yung PDF files on your Google Classroom.
Hi, ma'am. Thank you.
Welcome. Okay, now we will be continuing with the hypothesis and regression. So, this is the last topic under Module 4, which is the Unit 3. So, ang topic dito, so, titingnan natin kung ano si hypothesis. And how can we determine if it's a null hypothesis or an alternate hypothesis? So, discuss muna natin kung ano sa hypothesis. Hypothesis is a specific statement of prediction. So, nagpre-predict tayo. So, it describes in concrete rather than theoretical terms on what you're going to expect will happen in your study. Not all studies have hypotheses. Hindi po lahat ng studies have hypotheses. Hindi nyo pa yan ma-appreciate kasi you're still in the first year. Pero pag nandan po na yung second year, third year, baka meron na po kayong makakonduct ng study wherein great, magka-create po kayo ng mga research kasama po itong hypothesis. Pero may study po, walang hypothesis. Like yung gagawa po kayo ng mga equipment, hindi po kailangan hypothesis because it's a project-based study. Ayan. So, a single study may have one or many hypotheses. So, merong ding study, may isang hypothesis, meron din more than one yung kanyang hypothesis. Okay, so there are two types of hypothesis, the null and the alternative. So, how we can determine kung null hypothesis yan or an alternative hypothesis? Okay, so ito po no, the difference between the null and the alternative. So, si null po ay HO. Saan yung pencil ko? Yan. And si alternate po ay ang HA. Ayan. Si null hypothesis is a statement of no difference between sample means or proportions or no difference between a sample mean or proportion. Ay, sorry. Parang bumalik. Wait. Ayan. So, it is a statement of no difference between a sample mean or proportion and a population mean or proportion. So, in other words, the difference is equals to zero. Pero si alternative po, a claim po siya, claim that the population that is contradictory. So, opposite po siya, pag mayroong offense, defense po si alternative. Pag defense ng pansinal, offense po si alternative. Siya po yung nagko-contradict kay null hypothesis. Kasi ang gusto natin ay makonclude na we will reject. Hindi po natin tatanggapin si null, but tatanggapin po natin si alternative. Yan.
Permission to talk, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, cadet. Sino yun? Sino yung gusto mag-permission to talk? Si Tahil?
Nawala siguro signal, ma'am. Kaya putol-putol yung pananlita, ma'am.
Ah, okay. Okay, so going back nung kasi nawala siya. Wait lang. Admit ko muna si Ross. Okay, so yun po no, si null ay opposite kay alternative at kailangan po sa isang study natin, hindi po natin i-accept si null kundi si alternative. Okay, in a study, it is always the alternative hypothesis that we will accept, not the null. Okay, take note of that. Okay, the next difference nila. So, a statement of what is being investigated. So, sinalpo is a statement of what is being investigated. So, it is usually written in the negative form, such as, characteristic X has no significant effect. So, magsa-start po talaga yung hypothesis nyo. There is no significant difference between the two variables. Basta may makita po kayong mga not significant, no significant, no significant difference, yan po yung sinal. Pero kay alternative, opposite po. Wala po siyang no. For example, dito, no? Characteristic X has no significant effect. So sa alternative, characteristic X has significant effect. So tatanggalin mo lang yung no. Next, there is no significant difference between the two variables understanding. Null yan. Pero kay alternative, there is a significant difference. So, wala na yung no. Ito naman, X has not significant relation with Y. So, sa alternative, it will be X has significant relations with Y. So, tatanggalin yung not at saka yung no. In other words, ginagamit natin dito is equal sign, greater than or equal to, and less than or equal to. Itong null. Pero kay alternative, ito po yung gagamitin. Not equal or greater than siya or less than. Yan po yung kay alternative. Wala po siyang equals, wala pong equal sign. Ito dito, may equal siya, so that is a null. Ang walang equal sign is the alternative. Ma'am? Yeah. So, yun po, no? And then, yan. So, the difference between the two, no? Sinal po, may no significant, equal sign, greater than, equal to, or less than, equal to. Pero sa alternative, walang no, pero merong, ang kanyang sign is not equal, less than, pati greater than lang. Ayan. So, for example, to find out if blended learning is more effective than classes purely given in the classroom, the null and alternative hypothesis may be stated. Wait lang ah. So, paano yung null and alternative natin pag ito yung ating statement? We're going to find out if blended learning is more effective than classes purely given in the classroom. So, yung null and hypothesis will be this one. Take note, no? Si null hypothesis ay there is no significant difference. So, yan ang start kayo. There is no significant difference. Kasi gusto natin malaman yung blended learning is more effective ba sa classes purely purely given in the classroom. So, walang significant difference between the mean score if I'm going to teach in blended learning and in purely face-to-face. Yung alternative, meron siyang difference between the scores na tinuturo with blended learning and the scores na hindi tinuturo sa hindi blended learning. So, yun po yung difference between the null and the alternative hypothesis.
Sorry, ma'am. Nawawala ng signal, ma'am.
It's okay. Don't worry, no? If ever hindi po klaro-klaro yung boses ko dyan sa inyo, yung ating recorded, so just wait for the recorded, no? Kasi mga tomorrow pa yan or Thursday pa ma-upload. Pero hoping by tomorrow kaya na kasi yung Google Drive, pinaprocess niya pa yan. After our recording, pinaprocess niya pa. At maging available na yan siya. And then doon ko pa yan ma-upload, ma-download and then ma-upload sa YouTube. Okay, so yan. Going back tayo sa lecture. Okay, so yan po no, mga difference ni example, ng HO at saka HA. So, yan. Tingnan mo nyo, no? Dito ay HO. It's because merong less than and equal sign. Ito naman ay walang equal sign. So, therefore, that is your alternative. So, HO ito kasi may equal sign. Pag walang equal sign, not equal sign, therefore, that is the alternative. So, since may equal sign na naman to dito, then that is your null hypothesis. And this one is your alternative. Ayan. So, we're done with the null and, null and alternative hypothesis. So, we will continue. So, pasensya if medyo mabilis ako mag-discuss ngayon. No, it's because I am, kasi yun nga, no, grabe yung ulan ngayon. So, baka maabutan ako ng brownout. So, ipinapaspasan ko lang. Okay. Ngayon, sa regression analysis. So, this is the last topic under the unit 3. Kasi diba kanina sinabi, testing of hypothesis and the regression analysis. So, we're done with the testing of hypothesis. I mean, the hypothesis testing. So, we're in the regression analysis. So, ano po si regression analysis? So, from the term analysis, no, it analyzing the regression. Pag regression, diba, parang merong progressing siya. So, this is used when your study involves models. So, pag merong pong model yung study, yung mga model na nagmo-model ng mga damitan, yung models for the study yan. So, if your study involving models and analyzing several variables where the relationship includes a dependent variable and one or more independent variables. So, ibig sabihin, one dependent variable and one or more independent variables, so we will use the regression analysis. So, this is used to test the nature of relationship between a dependent variable and one or more independent variable. Basta meron na tayong dependent and independent variables, regression analysis na po ang gagamitin. Okay, so what is this model? So, ito na yon, si regression model. So, regression model specifies the relations of the dependent variable to a function combination of independent variables and unknown parameters. We also have a term known as regression equation. So, ano tong regression equation? So, if we're dealing with an equations, meron po tayong variables like the y, the x, and the sample size, which is your n. May term po tayong, may term po under regression analysis, which is the line of best fit. This is the equation of the line that best fits the collected data. So, yun, no? Meron tayong mga best fit. So, this is the formula. So, we have 1 equals 2 mx plus b. Going back, if you're going to relate this statistics formula, take note, it's like getting the slope of a line, di ba? Wherein 1 is equals to mx plus b. Going back tayo sa trigonometry. I don't know trigonometry ba yan. So, ang pagkuha ng ating slope of a line is y is equals to mx plus b. Ayan, no? This is the simple linear regression equation. Okay. So, we have linear regression analysis is based on the following set of assumptions. So, meron po tayong apat na assumption. First is the assumption of linearity, assumption of homozygosity, assumption of absence of collinearity or multicollinearity, and assumption of normal distribution. So what is this four assumption? The first assumption is that pag meron pong linearity, so we assume that there is a linearity. Therefore, it means that there is Nawawala yung line ko. There is a linear relationship between the dependent and independent variables. Yan po yung assumption of linearity. Pero if we assume that there is a homozygosity, so ang ibig sabihin niyan, the data values for dependent and independent variables have equal variances. So ibig sabihin, equal yung variances nila, so homozygosity po yan. Pag linear relationship po ang dependent and independent variables, that is the assumption of linearity. Okay? Number three, ano naman ibig sabihin if we assume that there is an absence of collinearity or multicollinearity? Ang ibig sabihin nito, there is no correlations between two or more independent variables. Yan po yung ibig sabihin yan. Pag walang correlations or walang correlations between two or more independent variables, ibig sabihin, there is an absence of collinearity or multicollinearity. And the last one, if we assume of normal distribution, then, anong ibig sabihin nito? The data for the independent variables and dependent variables are normally distributed. So, pag normally distributed po yung data ni independent and independent variables, therefore, that there is assumption of normal distribution. Okay, so yun po yung linear, yun po yung regression analysis. Ayan. So we have also the quantitative and qualitative. Ano yung quantitative and quali? So we all know, no? Itong quantitative is quanti. Ito naman ay quali. So if we are talking about quantitative education, quanti education and quali. So more on ang quali is more on numbers, ang quanti more on the product. Ayan. Tingnan natin, no? Ang difference nila. So quantitative research method, it describe and measure. So ito si quanti, describe and measure. Ibig sabihin, ang questions niya is mostly on how many and how often. And it is based on random sampling. While in the quali, it is more on exploration. So mag-explore po tayo in nature and underlying reasons and motivations. So dito sa quanti, it's either example, no, mag-survey ka, rate my teaching from 1 to 5. Yan ay quali, a quanti. Pero yung quali, how did you find my teaching? So sabihin mo anong reasons and mga underlying motivations. So that is the quali. So more on interview and in sentence po ang quali research. Ang quanti, yun lang, parang example, sa exam, ang multiple choice, parang quanti yan siya. Kasi itik mo lang, select mo, ay, A ang answer, B, C, D. Ang quali, yan po yung essay and problem solving. So, there will be different answers between one classes. Yan. So, this is, since we're doing the quali, so this is based on non-random sampling method. Unlike yung sa kabila, si quanti, random sampling ang kanyang gagamitin. Okay, so this is the difference between the quanti and the quali. So, yung requirements, no? And the ideal. So, tingnan nyo, no? Yung question niya, quanti, hypothesis, ang quali, wala. So, gagamitin niya lang interest. So, ito, no? Response, ang quanti, dito naman ay viewpoint. Example, yung response mo sa multiple choice. So, that is a quanti. Pero si quali po, viewpoint. What is your view on the teaching of your teacher on the mashup or in the NGEC 4? Yan. So, yan po yung qualitative. It's because Sa quanti, more on the numerical, and this one, more on textual, essay, viewpoint. So, yan. Okay. Tingnan natin, no? So, we will not more discuss this linear regression, no? As you can see, the linear regression, titingnan lang kung ano yung gagawa siya ng model. Ito na yun, no? Wherein, kinuha niya yung mean ng x, mean ng y. Ayan. And then, ito yung kanyang regression and we come up with this one. This is your linear model that will explain to the relationship of math score to the English score of a certain student. Okay? So, before we end, no, in conclusion or summary tayo. So, conclusion summary, so the statistics give us the overall view of reports that may indicate the changes of a given sample or population. So, it gives us an idea on how to analyze data using a specific statistical tool to interpret the data we gather. So, ibig sabihin, itong module 4 na ito, hindi nyo pa yan ma-appreciate because wala po kayong research. Pero paka sa second year, third year ninyo, may research na po kayo, gagamitin nyo po si statistics. Kasi mostly, in your masteral, yung after kayo mag-graduate, yung may mga teachers po kayo na mga marine engineer sila, they are taking their masteral and doctoral. And on that degree, they are required to do a research. So, since they are having research, they are need to undergo statistics subject. So, yung para sa atin, nasa taas lang po tayo. Hindi pa tong deeper part ng statistics. Okay? Ayan.
Parang basic pa lang po, ma'am, no?
Yes, basic lang po tayo. Parang you have an introduction. I'm sorry, ito pala wrong yan, aking deadline. So, you have an introduction lang sa statistics. You're correct on that. Okay, so I will not give you another activity, but you're going to have your quiz number 4 on Thursday. So Thursday, no, be ready and be available because it will all be available on 2:30 to 4 o'clock only on Thursday for quiz number 4 related to module 4. Sa module 4 lang tayo. Okay? So, do you have any questions?
Ma'am, may question ako, ma'am.
Yes, Cadet Francisco.
Ma'am, may given po sa quiz, ma'am, na quantitative at saka qualitative, ma'am?
I have no idea. Baka meron. Ang alam ko meron doon is you're going to get the mean, mode, median, and then may some definitions na pwede na isi-select nyo kung Spearman ba yan, point visceral, and other thing. I guess may meaning ata ng quanti and quali. And also, meron din yung null and alternative hypothesis. Yun.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. So, yun, no? So, if you don't have any question, more questions. So please open your camera for our documentation today. Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile. Isa pa, wait lang ah. Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay, class, thank you for your time. So, see you again on Tuesday, but be prepared on the Thursday quiz, okay? Thank you, stay safe, God bless. Bye-bye. Thank you, bye-bye. Ingat din, bye-bye. Bye.